Hi traders, welcome to Quantsapp and welcome back to yet another video. In this video, let's create a 10 important point checklist for our option trades, because in options a lot of losses happen because of errors instead of a bad trading view. So in this video, let's make a 10 point checklist and ensure ourselves that we avoid losing to trading errors. So to start off with, the first point is always have a bias on the markets. Okay, that does not mean you should always predict where Nifty is going to go, where Bank Nifty is going to go. No, but at least you should have an instinct. At least you should know what is your starting point and what you are going to do in the market. Are you going to find out an opportunity on the long side? Are you going to find out an opportunity on the short side? Are you going to sell options? The idea of your trade should be very, very clear. Okay, so one of the ways of forming and biases, you can go to builtup, you can go to script, and you can go to symbol. Over here, you will get to see all the stocks and you will get to see builtups for all the F&O stocks and indices as well, obviously. So if you see Nifty and Bank Nifty, both the instruments have witnessed a long buildup today. Nifty has gone up by 1.9%, Bank Nifty has gone up by 1.35%. And in both the indices, the open interest is going up, indicating that the bulls are convinced over here. The up move, it is backed up by additional participation. Further, if you just focus what is happening, 90 stocks out of total F&O scripts, so there are approximately 210 F&O scripts, out of which 90 stocks have witnessed a long and just 52 stocks have witnessed a short. Just think for a while. If you have something like this, if you have this kind of data on your screen, why will you place a bet against the market? So start your day by forming a bias. Start your day by knowing, should you go ahead and be long on market, should you go ahead and be short on market, should you sell options. How will you do it? You can simply do it looking at the screen. Second thing in the bias itself, what you can do is track the sectors or stocks which are in focus. So if you just look at today, what has happened is ITs, the mid cap ITs are in focus, followed by few you know, this one, the HDFC twins, which gained a lot of traction over here. So if you see, a lot of IT stocks are in focus. So if you would have seen this screen, you would have known that, okay, IT is the sector where you should find out an opportunity on the long side. So that is the reason, always start your day by forming a bias. So that is our first step. Second step is, we all know options, they are sensitive to a lot of variables, right? One of them is time. So avoid buying options and holding them for a lot of time, because they are wasting asset. Any which way, some premium from your options is going to get decayed because of time, right? So take a calculated risk. One of the ways of taking a calculated risk would be option chain and option chain what if analysis in it. So over here, you will get to see call option and put option. So 18,400 call is quoting at 104 rupees. Now let's say my target is let's say my target is 18,500. Okay, so I click on update. So over here, I get to see that, okay, my, if this happens right now, my premium, okay, my call premium is going to be 163 rupees, up by 59 rupees from the current level. But now the today is Friday when I'm recording this video. Saturday, Sunday, we can't do anything because markets are going to be closed, but that theta decays even on weekends. So what I can do is I can directly click on date over here and I can directly check. Let's say if I hold this option till let's say 10 in the morning, okay, till 15, you can do it by Monday as well. I'm just doing it till 15. So if you see, if this happens on 15th of November as well at 10 a.m., still I am making 30 rupees of profit on this premium. If you click on mark to market, that is roughly around 1487 rupees, right? So if yes, if you are happy enough with the returns that you are making considering the time impact, then definitely you can go ahead with it. Elsewhere, you can convert your strategy into a bull call spread, and elsewhere you can avoid it. Agar paisa nahi ban raha, you can easily avoid it. So second thing is, always be cautious about the time. One of ways to achieve it is by option chain what if analysis or option architect. I always say never employ, you know, ignore your implied volatility, because implied volatility is the second largest component that is affecting your option premiums. So never ignore your implied volatility. So you don't need to do any complex analysis. Just focus where you are placed on the implied volatility curve. How you will do? You can go to IV. You can go to IV chart. So over here, the orange line is showing you the implied volatility. The green line is showing you the futures price. It is showing you the data of last 250 days. The recent most data appears on the right and the oldest data appears on the left. So if you see, and you know, implied volatility has mean reverting characteristics and also positive relationship with our option premiums. That means if IVs collapse, call and put premiums will collapse. If IVs go up, call and put premiums both will go up. And also IVs will mean revert. That means they will come back to their normal regime. What is happening in the markets? If you see IV right now, it is at the lowest level. That means a lucrative opportunity to buy options because the premiums will be cheap. And if the IV spikes up, that will be benefit for me if I'm buying options. Similarly, if IVs are at top, what we should do? We should typically convert our naked option into spreads. Okay, we can, let's say on this day, if I'm bullish on the market, what I will do? Don't go ahead and randomly buy call options over here. Convert that into a bull call spread. So that, you know, the IV drop which has happened, the sole leg will take impact of that and that will not hurt you a lot. Okay, so simple, just come over here. If you see that, okay, this curve is, it is at bottom, that means the IVs are down, cheaper premium, better opportunity to buy. If the IVs are at top, that means the IVs are spiked up. There is a likely chance of IVs collapsing. Just convert them into a spread. Also, you can start selling options at that point with hedge or something. That is completely a different point, but just know where the implied volatility is. Now, fourth thing is related to implied volatility, which is event. Always be cautious about event happening. So which can be results, union budget policies, fiscal policy announcement, credit policy announcement, corporate actions, you know, Fed announcements, anything what might affect markets drastically. You should always have an eye over these particular things. Okay, so if you want to just focus on results, what you can do is just check out the result calendar tool. You will get to see all those stocks which are going to announce its result. There are multiple strategies you can build on these, you know, before the results. You can start buying options because the IVs will spike up once the results are done. Then again, you know, the IVs might collapse. So you need to go ahead and create yourself a hedge strategy or a spread. Okay, so result calendar is one of tool where you can stay updated with the any big events happening or specifically the results happening. And you can also stay tuned along with the, you know, these global impacts or these events on, you know, internet itself. A lot of information is freely available. Now coming to the fifth point, which is again very important, I feel, and a lot of traders whom I have interacted with, they go wrong specifically in this point, which is horizon. Always have a defined horizon for your trade. That means if you are trading options for scalping, be it your scalping trade, if you are creating a trade on volatility, keep that trade as a volatility trade. Third thing is, let's say if you are selling options, then keep it option selling, you know, a non-directional trade. Basically, what I mean is, whatever trade you are taking, stick to your view and stick to your instinct and stick to your initial forecast that you had. Okay. If you're buying a call option, then your view has changed, then you need to exit that call option, right? You can't go ahead and just convert your strategy from completely a bullish strategy to completely a bearish strategy. Just stick to your view, adhere to your targets and stop loss, and also adhere to the horizon of the trade that you have taken. If it was a scalping trade, keep it a scalping trade itself. If the move does not happen, just exit, right? And this applies to, you know, all the various strategies that you can take. So now coming to the sixth point, okay, so a lot of participants who join options or, you know, they might be knowing this, who have been trading options, liquidity, bid ask spreads. If you see, if the bid ask spreads are very big, the difference between the bid and the ask price, if it is very big, then just avoid it because you will face a big impact cost in that case. So you can go to liquidity finder over here. You will get to see the options liquidity has been rated based on, you know, the bar over here. More the rating, more liquid it is, less the ratings, less liquid it is. Okay, so Abbott India is really, really liquid. You will get a big bid ask spread over here. So you should typically avoid it trading in options, right? And another way is top 30 stocks in Nifty. That would be also really liquid. But always, you know, whenever you are placing an order, just check where the bid ask spread is. If it is very big, you should avoid it because you will face a big impact cost. Coming to the seventh point, which is ban list, always keep an eye on the stocks which might enter in ban, so that you know. So now you have the memory. Let's say if you're doing any research as well after watching this video, you know that okay, PNB is already in ban, GNFC might enter ban list. So these are the stocks you should avoid when you're trading in F&O, because they are in ban, right? So you can easily check if the stock is entering into ban or something, and if the stock is about to enter ban list, so you can completely avoid research in that. So now coming to the eighth point, which is trend. So this is one of my personal favorite points for today, which is trend. Never go ahead and place a bet against the market. That means if the stock has fallen 5%, that does not tell you it will fall more. It won't fall more. That does not tell you that it will completely change the entire history of the stock. Maybe if it has fallen 5%, it can go down tomorrow 3% negative as well, right? Always follow a trend. So now, if I just want to show you a chart of Nifty, okay? So let's say if I am just showing you the data since July 2021, see what is happening in Nifty. Long, long unwinding, long, long unwinding, long, long unwinding, and it keeps on happening, right? And whenever it was negative, what has happened? It was short covering cycle happening again, right? Whenever, if you see, just focus on this long, long unwinding. Typically, you know, whenever a stock is in a trend, this is how it will move up. It will always have longs. There will be pullbacks because of profit booking, and then again it will be long, right? But if you place a trade where there is everywhere a lot of selling happening already in stock, probability of your move going against you increases. So now the question remains, how you can go ahead and find out stocks which are in trend? So you can easily use the built-up cycle thing over here, okay? So by the way, trend is simple thing to find out by future OIH. All you need to do is just find out greens and blues for positivity. Reds and yellows will caution you. So if you even see Bank Nifty, okay? So if you just check out Bank Nifty, what is happening in Bank Nifty recently is a lot of longs and longs and windings are getting formed. If I just show you historical data as well, just focus on this, what happened? A lot of longs and few dips out to long unwindings. Okay, greens are showing you long, blues are showing you long unwindings, reds are showing you shorts, yellows are showing you short coverings. Over here, how it went down, short covering, short covering, right? So greens and blues for positivity, reds and yellows caution you. That is the trend. Now coming to the ninth point, which is futures built up. So by the way, trend has already covered about futures, but I will show you a trick over here. The trick is how you can find out stocks which are in clean trend. So you can use built up cycle for that, wherein green boxes are showing you longs, blues are showing you long unwindings, reds are showing you shorts, yellows are showing you short coverings. It is typically a scanner. Now I am saying the application consider the data of last 10 days, out of which find me out a stock which, or find me all those stocks which have long or long unwinding at least for 7 days. Okay. So now you are looking at futures data and you know that, okay, all these are the stocks where there are a lot of longs getting formed. So if I just want to easily pick up, if you see GMR Infra, just couple of shorts. If you Fin Nifty, I'll ignore it. Okay. But if you look at Hindalco, just couple of shorts, again, a clean trend. What happened today in stock? Again, a 3.4% up move. Jindal Steel, what is happening in Jindal Steel? So Jindal Steel, I have been tracking since a lot of time, because if you see, this is what is happening in Jindal Steel. Long, long unwinding. No short happening in Jindal Steel, giving a lot of confidence. So this is how you can use futures open interest to identify a stock. So from cycle screen, you can filter out 4 to 5 stocks and you can just check how exactly they are behaving on a, you can basically peep into the actual data and how they are behaving. Last step is you can never ignore options open interest data to see where the consensus level are, where the resistance and the support are. The green color bars are showing us call open interest, the red color bars are showing us put open interest. So over here, if you see in Jindal Steel, the futures built up was positive, strong. And if you see, it is around the highest call where the call writers are unwinding. The hollow, the tip, blank tip, which you are seeing, that is showing you unwinding. So what is happening in Jindal Steel? A lot of puts are getting added, okay, around the at the money. If you see, this is the strike where a lot of puts are getting added and the hollow is getting created on 500. Resistance is getting a bit weakened, but the support is getting strengthened along with the historical trend being positive. So you always look at options open interest data to time your entries and exits. If you are seeing that the stock is approaching its resistance, a heaviest call strike, or the stock is, you know, approaching its support, the heaviest put strike, you can, you know, take your actions accordingly. That means avoid buying exactly at the resistance and avoid selling exactly at the support, because that's where the pivotal levels are. So yes, folks, that was it from my side. This is our 10 important point checklist. Maybe you may not use this for your every option trade, but always have these things in your mind. And trust me, the moment you start using these things, your profitability and the errors, or I would say the losses you are making to errors, that will go, you know, down like anything. So thank you so much. If you have liked this video, do hit the like button, do hit the subscribe button, and also let us know in the comments what is the next video you want to, you know, make a video on. Thank you.